In part 3 of our lesson on graphs of sine and cosine, we will be extracting the graph of cosine from the unit circle. Remember now that on the unit circle, we have 3 variables. S is going around the outside of the circle. X is the cosine of S. And the third variable is y, which is the sine of s. So we're going to get the values off the unit circle and use them to turn it into a graph that has 2 variables in the xy plane. So first, take a minute and fill in all of these values. Of course, you can use the unit circle to help you accomplish that. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. We know that the cosine of 0 is equal to 1. The cosine of pi over 2 is 0. Cosine of pi is negative 1. Cosine of 3 pi over 2 is 0. Cosine of 2 pi is 1. Then going in the negative direction, we know that negative pi over 2 is coterminal with 3 pi over 2, so we know the cosine is going to be 0. Negative pi is coterminal with pi, so the cosine of negative pi is negative 1. Negative 3 pi over 2 is coterminal with pi over 2, so the cosine will be 0 there. Negative 2 pi is coterminal with 0 and 2 pi, so we know the cosine will be 1 there. Next, we're going to plot all those points in the xy coordinate plane. So because the cosine of 0 is equal to 1, we know that we plot the point 0, 1. Next, we'll have the point pi over 2, 0. Next is pi, comma, negative 1. Then 3 pi over 2, 0, 2 pi, 1. And in the negative direction, negative pi over 2, 0, negative pi, negative 1, negative 3 pi over 2, 0, and negative 2 pi, 1. Now let's take a look at how the graph of cosine is generated from the unit circle. As a point rotates around the unit circle, we know its x value will be the cosine of s. So when s is 0, cosine starts out at 1, and then it decreases until s gets to pi over 2, where cosine will be 0. As s moves towards pi, cosine will get more and more negative until cosine of pi is negative 1. And then as s moves towards 3 pi over 2, cosine goes back up towards 0, right at 3 pi over 2. Then cosine goes positive again until it gets back up to 1 at s equals 2 pi. So now we're ready to draw the graph. Remember, it's always smooth curves. There's never any straight lines. Smooth curves as you connect key point to key point. And going in the negative direction as well, we know smooth curves. And there's our graph of y equals cosine of x. Now we're ready to analyze our graph of y equals cosine of x. We can see that it is a periodic function. It repeats itself over and over again. And we can find its period by subtracting the endpoint of one interval minus the starting point of that interval. And in this case, we can do 2 pi minus 0. So we see that the period is going to be 2 pi. Now, it's also true that we could have found the period by subtracting the starting and end point of this interval over here. So we would have done 0 minus a negative 2 pi, so minus a negative would turn into a plus, and once again we would find out that the period is 2 pi. Now remember that the point traveling around the unit circle can go forever and ever and ever around the unit circle, so the cosine graph will go forever and ever and ever in both directions. So that means that the domain, which is all the possible values of x, is negative infinity to positive infinity. The range is the resulting y values that y equals cosine of x will output. We can see that the smallest y value is going to be negative 1, and the largest y value is going to be 1, so the range is going to be negative 1 to 1. The min refers to the minimum value of the function, which we know is the smallest y value that cosine of x will output, and that is equal to negative 1. The max is the largest y value that cosine of x will output, and that is positive 1. And the normal cycle will refer to the piece of the function that we're going to use as our standard one cycle of the function. And in this case, we're going to use the piece of the function that goes from 0 to 2 pi. So we can label that on our picture here. Here's the normal cycle. Starts at 0 and ends at 2 pi. We look at the five key values there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can see that there are two roots. So there's a root here at pi over 2, 0. And there is a root here at 3 pi over 2, 0. The normal cycle starts off at a maximum value of 0, 1. At pi, the function hits its minimum value, so that's going to be the point pi, comma, negative 1. And the fifth key point, the ending point, is a max at 2 pi, comma, 1. So those will be the five key values that we use for every graph of cosine. Max, root, min, root, max. Or in other words, 1, 0, negative 1, 0, 1. Next, we have to determine whether cosine of x is an even or odd function. Now, we know that the test for an even function is if f of negative x is equal to f of x. So in this case, we could pick cosine of negative pi and find out if that equals cosine of pi. Now, the cosine of negative pi is negative 1, and the cosine of pi is also negative 1. Those two are equal. That's what happens when you have an even function. Now, I strongly suggest when you do this test that you don't pick x values wherever the y value is equal to 0. You always pick x values that are non-zero when you do this comparison. Now, another way that you can tell if a function is even is if its graph is symmetric to the y-axis. So even functions are symmetric to the y-axis. Now, when we look at our graph of cosine, so for example, let's take the positive side. If we take the positive side of the graph and flip it over the y-axis, it exactly lands on top of itself. So that's another way that we can tell that cosine of x is an even function. Now we're being asked to find an equation which names all the roots of y equals cosine of x. So remember that roots occur at the places where f of x is equal to 0, which of course means the y value is equal to 0. And in an earlier lesson, remember we said that roots can be called x-intercepts. They can also be called the zeros of the function. So when we look at our graph of cosine of x, we see that there's a root at negative 3 pi over 2, another one at negative pi over 2, another one at pi over 2, and at 3 pi over 2. Now there are going to be infinitely many roots going in both directions of the graph, so we're going to have to come up with an equation for the roots. Now notice the distance between each root. The distance from negative 3 pi over 2 to negative pi over 2 is a distance of pi. From negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, the distance is pi. And again, from pi over 2 to 3 pi over 2, that distance is pi. So the distance between every root is going to be pi. Or you can think of it as starting at one root, you go a distance of 1 pi to get to the next root, you go a distance of 2 pi to get to the root after that, you go a distance of 3 pi to get to the root after that. So the way we're going to write our equation is, we're going to say that the roots are at x is equal to, we pick a starting value. It's common to pick the smallest positive value, so we'll start at pi over 2. And then we'll say you can go forward or backward by integer multiples of pi. So that would mean we're going to add n pi. So that's where the roots are going to occur at. And remember that n is equal to an integer. So once again, to make sure that you understand how this formula works, we would start at pi over 2, and we would either go forward or backward, depending on whether n was a positive integer or a negative integer, multiples of pi. So we could add 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, or we could subtract pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, so it would be minus 1 pi, minus 2 pi, minus 3 pi, and that would get you from your starting point of pi over 2 to all the infinitely many other roots on the graph of cosine of x. Next, we have a little summary chart for the sine and cosine graphs. So pause the video, go back through your notes, and fill in all of these boxes with the information that it's asking for, and then restart the video when you're ready to check, and I'll fill it in for you. Now the domain of sine of x, remember that's all the x values, was negative infinity to positive infinity, and that's the same for cosine of x. The range, which is the resulting y values, was also the same for both graphs. They both went from negative 1 to positive 1. The period of both graphs is 2 pi. That's the length of time it takes to go from the beginning of the cycle until the end of one cycle. The x-intercepts are different now. The roots of sine of x occurred at x is equal to n pi, and the roots for cosine of x occurred at x is equal to pi over 2 plus n pi. Sine of x turned out to be an odd function, because remember, it is symmetric to the origin. Cosine of x turned out to be an even function. It is symmetric to the y-axis. And then the normal cycle for sine and cosine, both of them, went from x equals 0 to x equals 2 pi. So this is just a quick summary chart to help you remember all the attributes of the graphs we just created.